Hey everyone, welcome to SGU and welcome back to some more Road to the Show. Today it's not Joe Broadway. Yeah, back by popular demand, we got another old friend rejoining the channel for content, and that is Skeeter Rabbit. Welcome back to the Rabbit. Recording this on Easter Sunday, so it seems very fitting that Skeeter makes his way back to SGU right now.
With the MLB draft already underway, a young prospect shares his expectations with a former coach.
All right, with Joe Broadway, we had a plan. I had a plan. I want him to play for the Red Sox this time around, or at least start his career there, barring any kind of trade to another organization. But with Skeeter, we're kind of an open slate here. I don't want to choose the team predetermined. I want to leave it to fate here and leave it up to the draft. Where will Skeeter Rabbit get drafted? Now, we don't do any of the showcase stuff anymore. We jump right into choices of a team. And you go straight into your minor league experience from there. I can't say that I really miss the showcase to start things off. I mean, it made sense. It made sense, but it was getting kind of tired. I'm totally fine with skipping that. So with all that said, where is Skeeter Rabbit going to go? Where is he going to get drafted in the MLB draft?
Carlos, you lived that in your baseball career. What's this world like?
Oh, it's extremely exciting. You know that if you perform, you will get the call.
We've got a developing story here. JP, what are you hearing?
I'm checking the numbers. I'm talking to my sources, my scouts, and they're all telling me, hey, this could actually work.
Most of us mere mortals, when we were that age, we were barely chewing gum and walking at the same time, let alone playing the hardest game there is.
Let's see if he's tough enough mentally here to adapt. That's what good players do.
That dream of getting the big leagues is now becoming reality with that one phone call.
All the hype is done. Now we sit and we wait to get the call. It is the Phillies. He's going to be in the Philadelphia Phillies organization. Wow. Okay. That should be interesting for Skeeter.
What? Are you kidding me? This is who we are drafting? You must be crazy. He is a career minor leaguer. He's not a major league player. We wasted a draft pick, a high one at that, here. This is why we don't win. This is a terrible, terrible pick. Oh, my goodness gracious. Come on, fellas. Do your work. Do some research. Awful, awful selection. I hate this pick.
Russo apparently hasn't been happy with any draft pick ever in the Road to the Show experience. That's just the way it is. You're going to have your doubters out of the gate. So speaking out of the gate, how about the debut in Double-A ball?
We're thrilled to be inside All-American Park. Opening day baseball on the show. It's the Somerset Patriots and the Reading Fightin' Phils.
So Skeeter Rabbit's career starts at Double-A Reading in the Phillies organization.
Skeeter Random getting ready to hit.
He's not the power guy, but he can hurt you to all parts of the ballpark.
Oh boy, some mistakes were already made. Did you hear him say Skeeter Random? Yeah, no, we don't want Skeeter Random. We want Skeeter Rabbit. Maybe it affected his first at bat there, grounding out. We also have some equipment issues. Got some equipment that is set up for bonuses, but we don't actually want being shown. The biggest egregious error, though, is that he's not wearing his trademark glasses. First of all, I can't just find regular-looking glasses. He's got to wear Oakleys or things like that, but I've got it set to always, I swear, and he's not wearing it. Obviously, because it's a night game, it thinks it shouldn't wear it, but why have the option to wear them always if you can't wear them always? He needs those. We've had that issue in other versions of the show as well. Hopefully we can work around it. Otherwise, I guess he's just wearing the shades for day games, which is a little bit of a disappointment. We're up 2-0 here right now, fifth inning. Still haven't gotten a hit, but playing our trademark center field out here with Skeeter. Going to cover a lot of ground, so he's not super fast yet. Like he's as fast as I can get him out of the gate with a few things set up, rituals and equipment and all that stuff. But yeah, it's going to take a while for him to become the huge base stealing threat that he's always been known for. We're going to have to work up that speed, earn it, I guess, as he flies out here in the sixth inning. We go top of seven now, 2-2 game, and this ball hit to right center. Yeah, he doesn't have to go very far to get that. he will get there and make the catch. But now Skeeter heads back to the dugout, still looking to get that first hit out of the way. He's 0 for 3 in this game. Obviously, he'd like to get it done in his very first game here. Got to get the nerves out and get that milestone taken care of. This ball is put in the air, and I don't think it's leaving the ballpark. It's going to be caught, and Skeeter's now 0 for 4. You see, this was the bottom of the eighth. He's probably not getting another at bat. However, Redding does win the game, so I get some team success. Skeeter will have to wait for that first hit at the double-A level as he goes 0 for 4 with three flyouts to right field. All right, so let's go fix a couple things. First of all, we got the audio taken care of. They'll say Skeeter Rabbit from here on out. I don't know why it said Skeeter Random. That was messed up. It said, we found the audio matching your name. I said, cool, let's go with it. And it gave me Random instead. The default. Anyway, all right, here we come out for another game. The other thing you saw in the menus is I went and double-checked that we've got the eyewear on to always wear, which is not the case, clearly, unless we're playing a day game. So I guess we're just going to have to deal with Skeeter not always having the trademark glasses, but what are you going to do? Here, a nice little play. Instead of throwing directly to third base, they get a nice relay going, and I don't know why he was going first to third there. He was hardly even in the screen there when the ball reached the third baseman.
Here's the center fielder, Skeeter Rabbit.
Okay, so we had the tough 0 for 4 in the debut. Still looking for that first hit. So first at bat of this game, he is going to hit a one-hopper to third base, and he's going to be thrown out despite his speed. 0 for 1 in this game. Pressing a little bit? Yeah, probably. Redding down 1-0, and that one is going to be backhanded by the third baseman. That is a heck of a play right there to make Skeeter 0 for 2 on the day. Ah, that's a bummer right there. But this one here, okay. Over the shoulder, and he turns course. Kind of a weird route to the ball, but hey, Skeeter gets it done, making the catch. That speed will make up for a lack of proper break on the ball, and he's able to correct things there. So they're down 2-0 here in the bottom of the fifth. He's 0 for 2. Yep, definitely looking for some luck on his side. Hit the ball hard, hopefully come through with a hit. And now there it goes, first base hit. Actually, he's going to be able to stretch this as it's down in the corner. He will easily have a double for his first double-A hit. Way to go, Skeeter. Congratulations.
And he might want to keep that ball for a souvenir. It's his first base hit here in double-A.
For sure, and if he can pick up a bunch more of those, he'll hopefully keep moving up the ranks towards reaching the big leagues. That's the ultimate goal for him at this early point in his career.
All right, so that's got to feel good to get that out of the way. He's finally got a hit here, and he can just kind of focus on barreling up the ball, which is exactly what he does here. It's a hot shot hit right at the first baseman, so a little bit of bad luck, but hey, they get the win again. Skeeter gets his first hit. Kind of a slow start batting average-wise, all that. You know, that is not going to last forever. Skeeter will be a quality hitter in this league. Contact first above all. Contact and speed is his game. Running those bases, putting pressure on opposing pitchers and defenses. So it's time to take on the Akron Rubber Ducks as we fast forward a little bit. Yeah, 100 average. Okay, well, something to improve on, obviously, as he's going to be able to hit that one through the hole. Second baseman can't come up with the play, and he's got a hit in his first at bat in this one. Looking to raise that batting average and his stock in double A here with the Phillies affiliate. And you got to see the ump get out of the way, shuffle his feet right there so he doesn't interfere with that base hit. He's at third base now, and bases are loaded, and, well, they continue to be loaded. Skeeter comes in, and the bases loaded walk. And it's going to be 1-0, 2-0 Redding when he comes to the plate again here in the top of the second. Already 1 for 1. Can he have a multiple hit game? Let's find out. 2-2 county works, and that one is going to be down for a hit to left. So, yeah, he is 2 for 2. Heating up a little bit. Maybe feeling a little more relaxed out there, despite the batting average coming along a little slow. But days like today with multiple hits will definitely help his cause right there. You see a couple different looks of him depositing that out in front of the left fielder. So it's a 3-0 game right now, and better break on the ball right there. Just back just a little bit to his right. Camps under it and makes a catch to end the inning. Let's see what Skeeter does at the plate. He's 2-for-3 at this point with the two singles and the run scored. And he definitely wants more. Today game, so he's got the shades on. Thank you. Still perplexed at the idea that you can't wear them always if that's an option. But hey, he's going to dump his third hit of the game out into left center, and it's going to drive home a run. 6-1 Reading Phillies now. And Skeeter with the three-hit game. Check this out. Not trying to do too much. Just take it the opposite way and get yourself on base. Bring a runner home. That's some quality baseball right there. Skeeter trying to take off, and we have not been able to steal yet, because most times when we do, the ball is put into play, and he's going to score easily on that one. Runner behind him scores as well, and they're starting to open this game up in the sixth. Now 8-1 on the double. They'll take the game. In the end, the Rubber Ducks could not outdo the Rabbit. 8-3 is your final. 14 hits, three of those belonging to Skeeter in a 3-for-5 game. Three singles and an RBI. Okay, that's definitely a step in the right direction for Skeeter. Going to get one more game here in our episode before we're out. Let's get back into the calendar. Pick one out for us here. And it's going to be another game against Akron, hitting in that three spot. We're 4-4 to start the year, are the Fighting Phils. All right, 387 the average now, looking much better here, 5 RBI. Skeeter's starting to figure it out. It's been just a small sample size, but look at that. Shot to right field. They're going to drive in another run. Yes, it will. There you go. Great way to start off your day with a solid single and an RBI. Hitting the lefty well here. Pitch on the outer side of the zone, and now he knows what to do with that. Take it the opposite way. All right, 2-0 at this point, bottom of the first, and I got a liner. Skeeter having no real problem with that. He's able to snag it. Keep runners off base. Is he wearing, why is he not wearing his shades in the field? I'm so confused here with the eyewear conditions. It makes no rhyme or reason. This ball hit into the gap in left center. Is it going to find some grass? Yes, it does. It rolls to the fence, and Skeeter's not stopping at second. He's going for three. The relay throw, not in time. We've got our first double A triple, probably, hopefully, of many yet to come. This is vintage Skeeter Rabbit right here, if you've ever watched his series before, using that speed. And he does just that, hitting the ball in the left center field gap and able to come all the way around to third base. Yeah, right center, that'd be a gimme, but he definitely showed the speed there to get it done with the ball kind of in front of him right there. So 5-0 right now. He's 2-for-3 and a seventh inning at bat coming up. He works a 2-0 count in his favor, a very rare at this point power swing, and he's able to get his third hit of the game. All right, we've got a couple three-hit games now. Looking good right here. You get that count in your favor, you're probably going to get a pitch. It's going to be much easier to put into play. He not only puts it in play, but look at the exit velo on that, 113. Man, that was smoked. All right, oh, a little bit of an adventure here, getting the break on this ball. Oh, man, right at the edge of the warning track. He is able to correct himself. Yeah, maybe if he had the glasses, he wouldn't be having the problem out there. Why are you not wearing the shades in the field? It's going against every rule I've set in the settings. I don't get it. Anyway, if anyone's got a fix for that where you can actually have them wear it all the time, please let me know. I mean, I get it if they're not going to let you wear them when it's not a day game. I mean, there's nothing I can do about that. But it's a day game. He's not wearing them out in the field. I am perplexed. Anyway, Skeeter Rabbit is back. I hope you're as excited as I am. Please leave a like, subscribe. And this is going to be a lot of fun having our old friends Broadway and Skeeter Rabbit back in the Road to the Show game here in MLB The Show 22. So until next time, see ya.